it's Michael J, and today I'm going to talk to you about one of my favorite costume designers of the 20th century, Raoul Pene du Bois. And I have here beside me, on my wall, a prized possession. It's an actual costume rendering by Raoul Pene du Bois. I have no idea from what show this comes. I haven't been able to identify it, and it doesn't have any markings on it that would say so, but I'm imagining it's probably from one of the musical reviews that he did. And in fact, he started with the Ziegfeld Follies when he was a teenager. And by the time he was in his young 20s, he was a well-established Broadway costume designer, and he also branched out and did sets. He worked in the movies a little bit, but mostly he was on Broadway for the majority of the 20th century. So, here's a little retrospective of Raoul Pene du Bois.
Raoul Pene du Bois came from an artistic family. His uncle was artist Guy Pene du Bois, and his cousin William was an illustrator. Raoul seems to have had a natural ability, for he had no training and got his start at age 16 designing a few costumes for the Ziegfeld Follies. Based on that example of his work, he became the full costume designer for the Ziegfeld Follies of 1934 and returned again for the 1936 edition. But he was also getting other remarkable assignments throughout his early 20s. One such assignment was the very American ballet Ghost Town for the Ballet Russe de Monte Carlo, for which he also designed the scenery. Here's an example of the finished costume alongside his rendering. He was learning on the job, for he was criticized for making the costumes too heavy and lacking in movement for dancers. At age 23, Raoul was entrenched in the monumental circus musical Jumbo, produced by Billy Rose. It's because of Jumbo that I came to know about Raoul Pene du Bois, because I used the show as my thesis project in grad school. While I was on a research trip in New York, I found that the Library of Performing Arts at Lincoln Center had a box of most of the Jumbo costume renderings. They were fascinating, both in the style of the renderings themselves and the fact that all his pencil notes were all over them, along with stapled fabric swatches. You can see from this combination of home movies and newsreel footage how big the show was and how it glittered like a dream. There were 200 people on this show, so it was a gargantuan effort for a costume designer. Billy Rose used Raoul a lot for his nightclub shows and his aquacade shows, seen here at the 1939 New York World's Fair. Thank you. In 1950, Ethel Merman had a big hit with Call Me Madam, one of her few Broadway roles she got to recreate for the film version. He did both the sets and costumes for Call Me Madam. The Music Man, a seminal classic, was the next huge hit of the 1950s for Raoul. The decade ended with another Merman biggie, a masterpiece, Gypsy. All the productions of Gypsy that followed the original more or less looked like this production, because Raoul based his designs on photographs of the real people on which the story is based. He was back again in 1974 to design the show for Angela Lansbury. The 1971 revival of No No Nanette exploded the 1920s style through a kaleidoscope of 1970s colors. The show brought Ruby Keeler out of retirement and back to Broadway and inspired a series of nostalgic revivals. Not a revival exactly. Sugar Babies brought Mickey Rooney and Ann Miller to Broadway in 1979. The show was a salute to the era of the burlesque revue. Raoul's hands-on background with the very kind of show Sugar Babies was emulating made him the perfect designer. In 2007, my play, Revolution, was produced in New York, and the costume designer assigned to the show was David Tozer. To my delight, David had been Raoul Pene du Bois' assistant from The Music Man on to the end of his life. We spent our first meeting talking all about Raoul, and I was tickled that my play was costumed by someone associated by one of the most significant designers in Broadway history. His last show was Reggae in 1980, but his Gypsy designs were used in Jerome Robbins Broadway in 1989. Raoul Pene du Bois died of a stroke in 1985. His amazing career spanned the majority of the 20th century, and his work will always be a source of inspiration to future designers.